Get ready to match the star. Buck Owen. Brett Summers. Gary Berghoff. Gloria DeHaven. Richard Dawson. And Patty Deutsch. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75.
Thank you, John.
How are you?
Good.
How are you?
When does that have to be back?
I've got it.
Everybody ready?
Look at Gloria DeHaven's nails. Wouldn't you love to have her scratch your back?
Listen. Oh, yeah, look at that. Can you get a shot of that?
I broke one.
You broke one. Look at how long those are.
Those are important. They're mines.
They are. Get them back to the Chinese embassy by 9.
You want to see something sharp?
Yes. Yeah. I beg your pardon?
Oh, thank you.
No, sit down.
Aren't they beautiful?
Look at that.
Those wow. Ain't they something?
I got to tell you something.
Ain't they something?
What?
You never
well,
know
where I come been. From, you have to wear sharp pointed ones because we use them for killing cockroaches in the corners.
Were those made from a little shiny cow?
No, I don't. He just shines them, that's all. I think we ought to press on now and say hello to our civilians over here, Sandy Vesco and Joanne Bengal. Hello, ladies.
Hi.
Sandy's our current champion. She's won $11,800.
Yes.
Now, listen, you haven't been able to think of what you're going to do with that money. Have you thought of anything yet? Can you imagine that? She doesn't know what to do with that money.
Is she married?
Are you married?
No.
No.
I'm not either.
And that's where it's going to be. All right. Now, she's going to be challenged by Joanne Bengal. We met her just as we left the air last time, and we found out that Joan is married and has 2 children.
No.
No, I'm wrong. No, wait a minute. Don't tell me.
She's only been married for 15 days.
Oh, that's right. She got married March 15th. It's all coming back to me now. And she has no children.
No. 44 a week, though, with preschool. That's...
Oh, yes. And she's a teacher. Yes, yeah. Preschool. All right. Good luck to both ladies. We'll start the game in a moment or so. Right now, we want to start this for you especially. Hello there. Are you ready? We are ready. Joanne Bengal, please make a selection.
B, please.
All right. Everybody plays. Got a brand new game here, folks. Tiny Tom Thumb said...
Oh, her again.
Quote. He said, you know the expression big people have? I'm so hungry I could eat a horse.
Uh-huh.
Well, us tiny folk have an expression like that, too. It goes, I'm so hungry I could eat a blank.
I knew that was coming.
You can spot that one. Did we telegraph the response there?
What was the first name?
It's Tiny Tom Thumb. He says, you know the big folks have the expression, I'm so hungry I could eat a horse?
Yeah.
He says, well, we tiny folks have the expression, I'm so hungry I could eat a blank. See, he's small.
I get it, honey.
He's, you know, the original one that was discovered...
By Barnum.
By P.T. Barnum was, I've read that he was 19 inches tall, I believe.
Yeah.
How big is he?
Oh, that's just about my size.
Is that right?
Yeah.
19 inches.
That's right.
That's about it, I suppose.
If we put a tablecloth under there, he could have taken a shower.
Yes.
Little devil.
All right. Joanne Bengal. You know about Tiny Tom Thumb?
Yes, I do.
Whoops. He said, the expression big people have is hungry, they could eat a horse. He said, well, we tiny folk have an expression like that, too. It goes, I'm so hungry, I could eat a blank.
A mouse?
A mouse. That would be the equivalent. Not a bad response there, Buck.
Well, to show you how I think, I thought if he's a big folk and you eat a horse, if he's a small folk, you eat a colt. A colt. That's a little horse.
Yeah, that's right. That's smaller than a big horse. Okay, keep trying, Buck. Don't be a quitter.
No.
Okay. Brett.
Thanks a lot.
Bigger than a mouse.
A cat.
And smaller than a horse.
It's bigger than a mouse and smaller than a horse.
A pony.
The pony.
Well, that's what I got.
That's what you got.
The pony.
Are the two dummies are following one another?
I didn't want the two dummies.
That's why I just changed it so I wouldn't be alive.
She's 0 for 12 on account of 0 for 12 today.
I believe
tonight.
You.
Tonight. Yes,
Gary, wake up, Gary.
Hello, Gene.
Hello there, Gary.
How have you been? I'm sorry to hear about your illness.
I'm all right now, though.
What am I talking about? That was... Yes. Actually, I was wondering why I said this, and then I realized that they used to build, did you know this is a little-known fact, they used to build Tom Thumb riding on a rodent.
Oh, they did?
They did. So I put a colt. No, I said a mouse.
There's one for you. Yeah. You approach it as if you've given the worst answer in the world and just flash it up there for a second as if you're ashamed of it. But it's a good answer and it matches and it scored
for
her.
I'm a great flasher.
Be proud. No flashing. All right. Hello there.
Well, now I want to say something. Mine is a very good answer.
It is.
Yes.
We'll be the judge of that.
But it doesn't match.
It doesn't match.
No, it doesn't. It's an ant.
An ant. So hungry I could eat an ant is what the tiny folk have in his expression. I'm so hungry I could eat a mouse is what she said.
Well, that's fair enough as far as I'm concerned. I don't want to argue with her.
All right.
She's quite wealthy. Do what Tom says, but do it
in a little voice like Tom.
Oh, well, of course. He was so short. His vocal cords were very short, and he talked in a very high voice. You see, we tiny folk, we have an expression, too. I'm so hungry, I could eat a mouse.
Yeah,
oh,
sure.
No, I could eat a horsefly.
That's good, eh?
Not as good as mouse.
That's right. As you got a mouse in your front, is that a mouse?
Clam marinara? No. So hungry, you could eat a newt.
A newt?
That's a delicacy for little people.
Sure must be.
May I ask what a newt is?
It's a lizard. It's a water lizard.
A newt.
Sort of.
And they often mate with rubber erasers.
That's right.
Is that what you mated with?
You had to ask.
She went to school with me.
Sandy, are you ready? Okay, she scored one celebrity match there. And now the first round question for Sandy reads as follows. Sylvia, the single girl, wanted to attract a doctor.
Uh-huh.
So, she bought a new perfume that smells like blank. She wanted to attract a doctor, so she bought a new perfume that smells like blank. Don't get those clues. We have to throw it out again.
Sorry.
We have to throw another question out. Okay. That's on account of you.
Now, come on now.
Okay.
Don't distract her.
No, she's playing for two. Be kind.
That's right. Leave her alone. Sylvie, she wanted to attract a doctor, so she bought a new perfume that smells like blank.
Okay. That settles it.
Are the pains quicker now?
I think so.
I've got to be on my guard.
I'm ready.
Everybody?
I am ready.
Okay. Sandy. Sylvia, the single girl, wanted to attract a doctor, so she bought a new perfume that smells like...
It's a toss-up between two. Alcohol?
Alcohol. Like alcohol.
This is her second drug.
Yeah. What is that?
Penicillin.
Penicillin.
Would you like to stick with alcohol?
Have you got a third choice? No. Okay.
I'd like the third one, please.
Buck?
Well, coming from an old family of doctors, I wrote chloroform, which is very close to alcohol and should be considered the same thing. I think that's a match. What do you say?
No, they say no.
All right, okay. Chloroform and alcohol.
All right, Brett.
Don't tell you anything, Buck.
Okay. Yeah, I think they got your number, Buck.
Yeah, I think so.
I think they do, too.
What do you got?
I'd say if you can't drink it, rub it on.
Rubbing alcohol.
There you go.
That's one match.
She did. She
keep
put
the ball
alcohol
rolling.
On to attract a doctor, and all she attracted was Brett. I don't know why, but...
Coffee
is
up.
Come on now.
Because I get the right answer all the time. Alcohol.
Alcohol. Here's your Sandy. You offer this girl a little alcohol.
Yeah, but I have a question.
Yes.
Yes. I think, now I don't know, but I think, isn't alcohol in medicine?
No. Medicine is too general and too generic. Now, before we give this girl any more alcohol, I think we ought to look at her ID card, don't you?
Yeah.
What do you offer this little girl?
I know what attracts doctors.
What?
Something that smells like cash. Make a house call for that.
What a perfume that smells like money.
Yes, yes. Well, this is also a little known perfume.
What is that?
Old Ace Bandage.
Ace Bandage. Smells like Ace Bandage. So at the end of round one, we have a nifty game going. Scores 2-1 in favor of the champ, Sandy. Round two coming up, but first this is coming up for your edification. Here we are. Ready to go to round number two. Scores 2-1 in favor of our champion, Sandy. Joanne, our challenger, will make a selection.
Be again.
Matched one last time. It was Gary. So the others will do this. The optometrist said to Judy, I've got good news and bad news. Good news is I've cured your crossed eyes. The bad news is now your blanks are crossed. I've cured your crossed eyes.
18 weeks.
Bad news is?
18 weeks.
Now your blanks are crossed.
I think I have it. I'm not dead sure.
Lower tier is ready. They're ready down here. We're waiting for you.
The upper tier is cheering.
I've cured your crossed eyes. The bad news is now your blanks are crossed. Okay. Here we go. Joanne. The optometrist said to Judy, I've got good news and bad news is. The good news is I've cured your crossed eyes. The bad news is now your blanks are crossed.
Bosoms?
Her bosoms.
Well, right from there.
That would be an interesting sight, wouldn't it? One going that way, one going that way.
Well, I had that operation. Now they're all right.
All right, but...
Well, cowboy singers evidently don't think like that. They straight arrows. And you... so I put legs.
Okay.
Cross.
Her legs are crossed.
Her... Cowboy singers.
Okay.
Think that way.
Cowboy.
Straight arrows.
All right, straight arrow.
Me.
Anything you say, straight arrow. Now, Brett, honeychild.
I wish I were an arrow. I'd shoot myself into the air, and where I landed, I'd care not where.
That just shows a card.
What'd that little devil say, that little Joanne? What's her
name?
The
bad news is now your boobs are crossed.
Good heavens.
I said something like that.
I think that's shocking. It's all right for a woman of my years to say boobs.
Yeah, but not me. Gary, you having a good time here tonight?
I'm having a terrific
time. Oh, you're having such a good time, you're not even going to get paid for this show.
I was born and raised in Bosoms, Connecticut. That's why everybody cheers when they hear boobs.
Thanks for the time. I could use it.
Wasting all that time. Show us your card there.
Well, normally I don't like sad stories, but this is what I put. I'm sorry.
Legs it is. Okay.
Well, I'd go show you two straight arrows.
Right. Straight arrows are sticking together. All right, Richard.
If Buck gets two more buzzes, he can make an album.
I've cured your crossed eyes. The bad news is now your blanks are crossed, and she said bazooms.
Is he looking at me? Is he cross?
No, he's not cross. He's
all
a big
right,
sport.
All right, boobs.
Boobs it is. Okay, that's three for you. Now, what do you say, my dear?
I said her upper frontals.
Her upper frontals. Why you? Okay. So the score is now 4-2. You have to score 2 to tie, 3 to win. Maid Marian said.
Booga booga.
No. Maid Marian said, my husband Robin Hood is a little bit weird. On our honeymoon, he brought along his blank. That's what Maid Marian said. My husband Robin Hood is a little weird. On our honeymoon, he brought along his blank.
You know, I thought that that Robin Hood and Maid Marian was the Tarzan and Jane story. I didn't realize they were married until
all
this
finished.
Very moment.
All through.
They finally did get married after he stormed the castle. Ready?
And it, what it was bad, mad, bad, and dangerous to know.
I think they got the answer in the front row.
We're going to find out right now. Are you ready, Sandy?
Right.
Maid Marian said, my husband Robin Hood is a little bit weird. On our honeymoon, he brought along his blank.
Bow and arrow.
You like that? You're booing a lady who's won $11,800. Are you out of your mind? All right, we'll find out. She said bow and arrow.
Well, us straight arrow tennis players always take along a bow and arrow, folks.
All right. Score is now 4-3 in favor of Joanne. You need one more to tie. Brett.
You know what I say?
What?
Give me 10 men, 10 stout-hearted men that are brave.
He brought along his men.
What?
Oh, you're not supposed to play.
Well, me neither. Oh, let me play. This is a terrific game. Can I show you what my answer was?
Get out.
They had prunes at the wedding, so he brought along his little John. That's all right.
How about me?
You do play.
Well, now, I didn't think it was necessary to bring along the bow, but I certainly thought he ought to bring his arrow.
Oh, that's good. We'll take that.
Huh? We'll take that, and that ties the score. All right, Richard.
They were never married.
They weren't?
Cheetah and Maid Marian.
Oh, no, Robin Hood and Maid Marian.
Oh, that's a different story entirely. And he was weird. He brought along his merry men.
His merry men.
Oh, boy. All right, score is tied at 4-4. If you say bow and arrow, Sandy will win another game.
What happens if I say he brought along his Friar Tuck?
His Friar Tuck. You say Friar Tuck, the game ends in a tie. We're going to have to go to a tiebreaker. But right now, we've got to go to this commercial message of terrific importance, especially to me.
Today's consolation prizes are a Westclock digital dial and alarm clock, wood grain finished lighted dial, backed by years of experience, Westclock, the Tally Industries Company. And Regal wears beautiful Mardi Gras cookware and new porcelain clad aluminum, the Super Hard Teflon 2 and matching poly perch. And new Purina Meow Mix for your cat. Tasty, nutritious combination of tuna, liver, and chicken flavors. Purina Meow Mix. Stay alive with Match Game 75 when it continues in a minute.
Here we are all together. Okay. Game ended in a tie, as I said, 4-4. And we got to break the tie, so we'll clear the board and push the button. Go to one tie-breaking question for each. The one who scored the most will be the winner. Joanne, please make a selection.
B again.
B it is. Tie-breaker question. Everybody plays. The circus owner said, boy, am I in big trouble. The bearded lady just blanked. The circus owner said, boy, am I in big trouble. The bearded lady just blanked. Okay. Everybody ready down here? All right. Now we'll get a response from Joanne Bengal. The circus owner said, boy, am I in big trouble. The bearded lady just blanked.
Shaved off her beard.
Shaved. She said, the bearded lady just shaved.
Without a doubt, I stood there and watched her.
Shaved.
Shaved.
Attaboy, Buck. Now, Brett.
I say, if you want to grind it, wait till you've refined it, or shave it off.
Shave it off. That's two. And Gary.
And I said shave.
You said shave.
I sure did.
That's three. You're really doing well with this one.
Shave.
That lady shaved. Boy, oh boy. Now, what do you say, sir?
I say, tell him to,
Yes, sir.
Shave.
Tell him to get another bearded lady. Now, lady.
Yeah?
With the hair in your eyes.
Yeah.
What do you say?
Shave.
You shave. All right. You gonna go some? Sandy, you got your work cut out for you. A little riddle for you now. What time is it when your elephant sits on your picket fence? You give up, don't you? All right.
Yes.
It's time to get a new blank.
Oh. Could you read that one more time?
A little riddle.
Yes.
What time is it when your elephant sits on your picket fence? You give up? Yes. It's time to get a new blank.
Will you have lunch with me tomorrow?
Yes. All right, we're getting close to the end. Do it as quickly as you can, if you please. Thank you. All right. right, Sandy, a little riddle for you. What time is it when your elephant sits on your picket fence? You give up. It's time to get a new...
fence.
Time to get a new fence. Got to match everybody, but...
fence!
There is one fence for you. What do you got, Brett?
No, certainly not elephant. I say get a new fence.
Get a new fence. Got to match everybody.
Fence.
That's three fences. And you?
Fence.
Another fence.
I hope you won't take a fence.
And five fences. That's two ties in a row. At 6-6, as you can plainly see, and we're going to figure out what we're going to do right after this message. Here you go. I tell you what we're going to do. We're going to stop right now and put both of you ladies in cold storage. And next time we get together, we'll see what we can do about breaking this tie. All right? I'll push the button. We'll have a couple of more tie-breaking questions for you. You were all just Jim Dandy.
Oh, thank you. Oh,
how much time we got? 30 seconds. 20 seconds there. Uh-huh. Well, here we are with 20 seconds. You'd like to sing? All right, sing a little song.
Well, MASH, Tuesday night, 8:30.
How about Melancholy Baby?
MASH on CBS every Tuesday night. Terrific idea. Gene Raymond, goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.